Today I rise in opposition of House Bill 1437. Simply put, this budget is just more of the same. I cannot support any budget that severely underfunds education in Pennsylvania for a third year running and fails to properly fund senior programs. This budget is almost identical in the spending cuts proposed in the governor's shameful budget proposal. When this budget was first introduced and I had the opportunity to look it over, I couldn't help but say out loud, we can do better than this. After cutting nearly $1 billion in the first Corbett budget, we can do better than the relatively insignificant $100 million addition proposed in House Bill 1437. After watching the Philadelphia School District undergo a massive overhaul that saw mass cuts to vital programs, I can say with certainty that much more is needed if the members of this esteemed chamber ever plan to say in good conscience that we are doing everything we can for the children of this Commonwealth. For those members of this chamber who speak in dollars and cents, let us not forget for a second the correlation between investments in education and the future economic success of this state. We can do better. From one vulnerable yet important demographic to another, House Bill 1437 fails our senior population. This failure is not due to a lack of effort. Rather, this failure is due to a lack of vision. The plan to outsource the Pennsylvania Lottery is short-sighted and imprudent. The lottery is on track to exceed last year's record for ticket sales and profits. Why is selling this guaranteed source of revenue even an option? We can do better. I am certain we can do better because my colleagues and I have supported a proposal that would keep the state-run lottery intact while generating even more revenue for senior programs. See, we can do better. When I think about the potential revenue this budget ignores, I become even more frustrated. How can House Bill 1437 pass once again on the opportunity to tax one of our state's biggest resources, Marcellus Shale? A responsible natural gas severance tax on Marcellus Shale drillers would provide $142 million to help meet Pennsylvania's needs. It is reasonable that we ask drillers in Pennsylvania to pay what they pay in every other state. We can do better. We have the opportunity to truly close loopholes for multi-state corporations. We can do it. We can expand Medicaid like 23 other states are doing, including our neighbors in New Jersey and Ohio. We can do it. All it would take is more diligence, a greater commitment on behalf of the members of this chamber to try, in good conscience, to get it right this time around. We owe it to the citizens of this Commonwealth to put forth a budget that is in their best interest, because isn't their best interest ultimately ours? We can do better. So let's do it. Let's do what the skeptical citizens of this Commonwealth are betting that we can't do. House Bill 1437 is not a bill that works in the best interest of Pennsylvanians, and it is not something that I could put my name behind. For those reasons, I am giving a no vote, and I urge all of you to do the same.